14th. Tomorrow, of course, is January 15th. The birth date of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. This week, we're going to be immersed in the dream, Dr. King's dream. People don't realize that Dr. King had awakened from his dream of 1963 into the nightmare that became 1967 and 1968. What I'm going to do today is I'm going to put together pieces that I created related to Dr. King's speech, sort of like a call and response to Dr. King's speech in 1963, to what Dr. King was facing and what we face in 2023, and what Dr. King faced in 1968 before he was assassinated on that balcony at the Lorraine Hotel Motel in Memphis, Tennessee on April 4th. Dr. King said, "I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. Dr. King knew one thing prior to his dying. Dr. King knew that America's creed was about lying. Dr. King understood that equality was supposed to be transparent. But in America, Dr. King found out equality was aberrant. Dr. King found out later in years that inequality for Black Americans was inherent. Dr. King felt that with the passage of race laws, equality would resolve and inequality would dissolve. But those truths weren't self-evident because America was so improvident. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. Yes, Dr. King had a dream, spoke about a table of brotherhood. But King didn't mention anything about the blighted Black neighborhoods, or the fact that 60 years later some folks would still be wearing white hoods, or that some folks 60 years later would still be passing falsehoods, and the Dagwoods and Dogwoods of Georgia would still be restricted to the white hoods. That table of brotherhood, well, that is now situated in the backwoods. 60 years later, Black men would still be fighting for their manhood. I have a dream that one day, even in the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. Mississippi's fate of justice restored definitely is late. The freedom King sought wasn't caught. That oasis wasn't brought. That sweltering heat hasn't been beat. The oppression ain't gone. It's just an American con. And poor Black folks in Mississippi are still pawns. They are still waiting for Mississippi to dawn. I have a dream that one day down in Alabama, with this vicious racist, with his governor having its lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullification, that one day right in Alabama, little Black boys and Black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today. Has Alabama changed since 63? Or is Alabama's tide then simply rearranged? Or Alabama ain't calling for nullification just as long as Coach Saban's Black football team is leading the nation. because little black boys are now on a quest to play Alabama football better than the rest. But still, Alabama's black schools are still a damn mess. And plenty of black boys in Alabama fail literacy tests. They don't join hands 60 years later in that dream of hand-holding. Well, Dr. King is still black white folks are still scolding. And finally, the dream. In August of 1963, Dr. Martin Luther King spoke of a marvelous dream. You see, by 1967, King's dream began to lose steam. Why? Because many Americans were not part of King's team. You see, some Americans were plotting and scheming, while Dr. Martin Luther King was caught daydreaming. King spoke of the evils of war, avarice, greed, and poverty, while the nation, America, he spoke to, loved war, avarice, greed, and undistributed wealth. So something had to change. King's words had to be rearranged. You see, too many in America, King's words seemed strange. Hell, some Americans even called King deranged. So they silenced the dreamer, they killed the dream. And this nation went back to being really racially extreme. And King's words are now a part of a marketing thing, selling everything from Dodge trucks to facial cream. The dream, you know, King's dream, oh, it's now the meme. That, America, is a hell of a way to treat that dream. Thank you on King's Day 2023.
About your past.